Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Another crazy division you built video, and today you're gonna see how 500% shield health regen looks like in the game. Basically, you're gonna be unkillable, untouchable, walking god. It's absolutely ridiculous, and actually you have a couple ways how to build ridiculous build. For example, you could use protection from elites, but unfortunately that will not protect you from those non-elite enemies, and they can be really nasty, like those rushers with drones, grenades. So in my eyes, Reaper skill is a little bit better if you wanna attack legendary difficulty, or you could use armor regen set as well. They are pretty dope. For example, Bulwark, excuse me, set, or maybe pair it up some regen with exotic regress strike chest piece or memento backpack. So you have a couple options, but today we are using Sleeper, exotic BTSU glass, man. Nobody is running them, especially with Dark Winter SMG. Name it SMG with perfect killer talent, and that bad boy will hit like a truck. Actually, Dark Winter works really nice with technician specialization. The synergy is absolutely outstanding because you can apply linked laser pointer attachment on your Dark Winter. So I think you know where I'm going with this one. Of course, I will use Spotter talent. It works really nice with Perfect Killer because Spotter has no range limitations whatsoever, just like Perfect Killer. And if you're gonna pair up both of these talents, you will have ridiculous damage in the range. You could use Intimidate, but then you have to be in 10 meter radius, so close range battle, and I don't know, man, sometimes it can be really tricky, especially on legendary difficulty, everybody gonna flank you. So I think Spotter and Dark Winter is really strong. But before we continue, I just wanna let you know that we have some sponsor ads. And guys, if you don't have enough time or good teammates, but you still want to have all the best items in your game, then Deviant.net is set for you. They have absolutely amazing team on Xbox, they will complete your order twice as fast. Now, everything happens with account sharing. This service has been working for many years. It has tons of customer reviews. You can check everything by yourself. But now with my promo code RBDIV, you will have 15% discount on all services. It's an amazing deal, especially when right now this site supports a ridiculous amount of games. And if you have any questions, I will leave a link down below in my description so you can contact them through the WhatsApp basically immediately. But now let's get back to my Dark Winter legendary build. But before we continue, I just wanna give you some pro tips. For example, on heroic difficulty, guys, please use exotic Sweet Dream shotgun. That will allow you to speedrun basically any mission in the game on any difficulty, except legendary difficulty. Why? Because Sweet Dream shotgun will one-tap non-elite enemies, and that can save you a lot of time. So keep that in mind. But for legendary difficulty, guys, Scorpio is must have, because most likely you're gonna fight Chungus with Stinger Eyes on their backs, Rogue Agents, maybe Hunters if you wanna fight Summit Floor 100. Again, Scorpio is really handy because that will apply, of course, status effects are gonna shock your enemy, and with full stacks applied, you basically all incoming damage will be increased also from your teammates. So Scorpio shotgun works really nice in team play, not only in solo play, but in heroic difficulty you could easily swap shield for any skill you like Defender Drone, maybe Seeker Mine, or some healing skill, because you don't need anything with that. And of course, we have a couple ways how to play with this set. Actually, three ways. Yeah, you could invest everything in crit damage in mod slots, That's one. Second way how to play with this build, do like I'm doing right now, use Reaper skill. That basically will heal your shield every 7 seconds, 70% Reaper skill. What it means, each 7 seconds your shield will be healed by 70%, but we have of course one little dirty secret as usual, name a pistol which will make you, your heal even stronger, because pistol will give you one extra skill tier. And third one of course is protection from elites, but hey, if you want to be updated with all the best PvP, PV builds, you know where you have to be. Subscribe, hit that like and share that video. I just wanna reach 30k subs before this year ends. So with no further ado, let's get into 30k subs. Yo, you see how this build is beautiful? Right now I'm showcasing you how 500 shield health regen looks like. Again, you're gonna be untouchable, unkillable. That shield health is not moving anywhere. Absolutely ridiculous, and I have to remind you, that's legendary difficulty. And again, I'm rushing. For specialization, guys, technician is must have. It will provide us with one extra skill tier, which will increase our artificial hive strength or efficiency and shield health in general. But most important part, the technician specialization will provide us with linked laser pointer attachment, and we can use it on our Dark Winter SMG. And you know what it means? We're gonna use spotter talent. Basically, you're gonna aim at any enemy or target in the game, and that will immediately activate spotter. And spotter is amplified weapon damage and skill damage. But the best part about Dark Winter, a perfect killer talent, that it has no range limitations whatsoever, just like spotter talent. So in my eyes, that's perfect combination. For example, if you want to use sadist or the same intimidate talent and chest piece, both of these talents has range limitations, or perfect close and personal talent, you should be in close quarters, you should be in close range. And in my eyes, those talents works better with armor regen set, or maybe with Boulevard, but not with Reaper skill build. And again, Reaper skill build is really handy, and those elite enemies will not get to you anyway, because the shield will not go anywhere. Again, legendary difficulty, summit, directive supply, no problems whatsoever. And this build is really versatile as well, guys. Don't worry, if you don't wanna play with artificial hive and shield, you can easily replace those both skills. You can use protection from elite mods as well here. It depends on your preference. But for second gun, you should use Sweet Dreams on heroic difficulty. On legendary difficulty, you should use, of course, Scorpio shotgun. Sweet Dreams will one-tap non-elite enemies, so that's the reason why it's super strong on heroic difficulty. You're gonna speedrun any mission in the game, but Scorpio shotgun, well, basically gonna stop any Chungus, Hunters, Rogue Agents, you name it, and with full stacks applied, all incoming damage also from your teammates will be increased. So that gun works really well in solo, aka lone wolf mode, and in team play. But my dirty secret is this pistol. DDR with one extra skill tier that will make our artificial hive ridiculously strong. It will heal our shield by 90% with each charge, and we will receive our charge in 7 seconds. So each 7 seconds our shield will be basically healed with full health or full health back. You could use of course perfect future talent there, but I think Instinct is a little bit better there. Sadist of course is not that important, but as you see, anyway, we have ridiculous survivability. Adrenaline rush will help us to deal with those stingers, with that bleed, and my armor is not moving. Again, my shield health is not moving. I am face tanking hallway with 3 Chungus, all the skills, drones, explosions. So again, I'm using this build with Reaper skill because in my eyes that works a little bit better than protection from elites. Of course, it depends on your preference. You can make this build around protection from elites, use maybe defender drone and run without shield. But There are a lot of non-elite enemies, and they are nasty. Those rushers, the drones, seeker mines, not seeker mines, but the grenades, can be really annoying. So I think best option is to run with your shield, and Reaper skills will allow you to basically run around with the shield non-stop. For backpack, I'm running Walk and Harris, perfect adrenaline rush. For one enemy, I will receive 23% bonus armor. Super handy for my stats. Everything is really nice. We are sitting basically at cap, and the perfect killer talent active, I will receive extra 50% crit damage boost. So pretty strong build. For my chest piece, I'm using Sokolos with Spotter. Spotter is amplified weapon damage. It will be activated with Linked Laser Pointer attachment, which works with Dark Winter. And both of these talents has no range limitations. Perfect Killer and Spotter has no range limitations. And so yeah, this is my build in a nutshell. But you could, like I said before, you could play with protection from elites, with armor regen, or maybe with Reaper skills. So this build is really versatile, but I love all the synergies we have in this build right now. So of course you can change everything how you like, but I found this the best or useful way how to play. And of course my little dirty secret in this build is exotic BT2 gloves, because they will proc overcharge. I can destroy my artificial type, I will get overcharge, and with that my shields will be unkillable. Pretty dope synergy. And BT2 gloves as well have Reaper skill attribute. So again, everything works really nice together in this build. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.